What's up guys, Sal here. So while all of our eyes were set on the Galaxy S21 coverage in the past few days, Samsung quietly showcased its first under-display camera technology. Yes, the company is now ready with its first product with an under-display camera. Strangely, it's not a phone, but a laptop instead. Samsung showed off a product preview of the Samsung Blade Bezel laptop, which will have a nearly bezel-less display with a 93% screen-to-body ratio. One of the USPs of this laptop is the under-display camera. Now, the Galaxy Z Fold 3 is also expected to have this technology, and you might be surprised to see their laptop incorporate this tech before the star of the show could bring it in. But it does make sense. You see, the quality of front-facing cameras in current laptops is straight up trash, to be honest. So even if the quality of the under-display camera on these laptops turns out bad, users are not gonna notice. But what they are gonna notice is the immersive edge-to-edge display that does make a huge difference. Now, speaking of the under-display camera, if Samsung decides to equip the Galaxy Note 21 Ultra launching later in the year with the under-display camera technology, then this is what it will end up looking like. In an official video, Samsung showcased this handset, which looks like the Galaxy Note 20 Ultra with that boxy design, but there's no hole for the front-facing camera. Now, I'm not saying this is the Galaxy Note 21 Ultra, I'm certain it's not. Most of the smartphones Samsung uses for their commercials have edge-to-edge screen. In fact, most of the times, the screen on these phones is not even real, but they are edited in post-production. But like I've said, if Samsung decides to go with this tech, then this is the closest representation of what the Galaxy Note 21 Ultra will end up looking like. So when Huawei unveiled their latest chipset, the Kirin 9000, it created a new record for the highest clock speed in a mobile chipset, clocking in at 3.13 GHz with its prime core. The latest flagship chipsets from Qualcomm and Samsung runs at a lower clock speed at 2.84 GHz and 2.9 GHz for Snapdragon 888 and Exynos 2100. So Huawei still had that record, but that changes today when Qualcomm unveiled their new chipset, the Snapdragon 870, with a clock speed of 3.2 GHz. To be honest, the Snapdragon 870 is not a new chipset, but basically an overclocked version of the Snapdragon 865 Plus with the specs being literally the same. So basically, it's the Snapdragon 865 Plus Plus. Now, having a better clock speed doesn't mean it's faster than the Snapdragon 888. The 888 CPU is based on the newer Cortex X1 and A78 instead, so while it runs at lower frequencies, the 888 will still be faster as there's more to the performance story. We'll have to wait for the first benchmark to see how exactly all of these chips compare though. By the way, the Snapdragon 870 will be seen in a lot of value flagship smartphones from companies like Motorola, OnePlus, Oppo, Xiaomi and more. Of course, with that being said, let me know what you think about this down in the comments. And as always, I'll see you tomorrow. Peace out.